To ask me is in vain. For who goes up your winding stairs will never come down again. Looks like it's almost time to change your bandages again. Should probably go do that now. Oh. You're actually awake this time. How do you feel? Yeah, considering the sedatives I've had to give you, groggy is not that surprising. Well, you've been out of in and out of consciousness for the past how long has it been? About 2-3 weeks now. Yeah, had to get you hooked up to an IV. Couldn't have you dying on me from dehydration after all. Don't worry, I put the needle in right. I know somebody who works at a hospital. I asked him about this sort of thing before, so I know it's a thing or two. Well, I had to be prepared when I got you here. Luck favors the prepared, after all. Yeah, I was wondering when you'd realize again your legs are gone. That shocked reaction seems about right. Okay. Yeah, I deserve being called that. And that. Yeah, that's all fair. I honestly can't blame you. Not at this point. Okay, look. I'm gonna go get the bandages, and I'll be right... Look, I have to go get the bandages to change the ones you have on, okay? I can't risk you getting an infection. Yes, an infection in your amputated legs would be worse than me Okay, it wouldn't be worse than what I did to you, but getting an infection like that could probably kill you, so it would be pretty bad, okay? So let me just... I deserve that. I deserve a lot more than getting a lamp thrown at me, so. Yeah. I'll be right back. Just sit tight. Don't go anywhere. Okay. Just hang on. Let me get these bandages off you. Why I'm bothering to help you? I told you before. I don't want you to die. I wanted to be able to take care of you. That's all. Yes, I have a funny way of showing it. I know. I know. Just, Let me finish this, alright? Quit squirming. I know it hurts. Just... I know it stings. I have to make sure it's tight, though. Can't have you bleeding out on me. Okay. All done. If you don't mind, I'm gonna have a seat on the floor next to you, so... Feel free to pull on my hair if you want. Or whatever. I don't really care. What am I doing? What does it look like? Rather not have shards of glass stuck in my face, if you don't mind. I mean, you probably would want them to dig deeper and deeper into my skin until they pierce the other side of my face. But I'd rather not. It'd be more of a hassle than anything else. What? Laughing at the dark circles I have under my eyes now, too? No. I haven't really gotten much sleep. I've been up most of the night just taking care of you. Yes, the crazy person has been taking care of you and losing sleep over it. Shocker. Look, I just wanted to make sure you were gonna be alright, okay? That's all. Since you're awake now, if you have any questions you want to ask me, since I'm feeling generous, I'll answer them. Okay? That one, I honestly wasn't expecting. I was more so expecting something along the lines of why I took you, or something like that, you know. But why I'm like this, that's actually pretty surprising. Oh, okay. I can't really explain it myself. I'm pretty sure I might have a mental disorder that hasn't been diagnosed yet. We don't know. But there's also my upbringing that could have had something to do with why I'm so fucked up right now. You know how it goes. Dad doesn't give a shit. Beats the kid if she so much as steps a toe out of line or breathes wrong while he's around. Mom's apologetic for him and only cares as long as daddy's happy. Fuck all to the kid she had, right? Then the people at school, they tease and taunt her. They don't understand that she's going through shit at home. They just think she's the school freak because she's afraid of talking and socializing. You know, same old to every Cinderella story.
Yeah, it was pretty bad, honestly.
Bruises on my back. I'd even have a busted lip every now and then. Mom always made excuses when the school called. She fell running outside, or she's a clumsy kid. Of course, most of the parents of the other kids knew. It's always funny how the adults always seem to know something, but no one really wants to do anything about it. They feel like they shouldn't interfere. And so they pitied me, and their kids pretty much just made fun because I was the weirdo girl that everyone seemed to feel bad for, blah, 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 blah. And then there was you. You were always so nice to me. Even when other people made fun, you didn't join in. You gave me the time of day. You didn't look at me with pity. You didn't see someone who came from a broken home, someone that was beaten and battered. You just saw a person. You helped me feel somewhat normal. I guess the lesson in all that is be careful who you're kind to, huh? Are you actually petting my head right now? Gotta be fucking kidding me. Like I'm gonna fall for the same trick twice. Believe me, hun, I'm not falling for your little attempts at affection anymore. I know they're complete bullshit now. No, it wasn't affection. It was what? You feeling bad for me now that you know how messed up I am? Save it. I don't need it. I don't need you to pity me. Don't. I don't need pity. Just stop. Stop. All right, just. Just stop talking. Please, just. I should go bandage up my wounds. Really need to drop the BS right now, okay? I know you don't give two figs about me. I could drop dead right now, and the only thing you'd be worried about is getting out of here. Shouldn't I care about my wounds? I should, shouldn't I? Honestly, I couldn't give two fucks about my own wounds. I really couldn't care less. I could bleed out on the floor right now, and it wouldn't be a travesty. Not at all. Who would miss me, honestly? The mother who only cared about pleasing her husband. The father who took his anger out on everyone else. Or the poor lost boy who got tangled up in the spider's web and lost his legs because of it. No one would miss me. But I guess I should. After all, I'm the only one here taking care of you. Can't have you dying on me now, can I? And if I die, no one knows you're out here. Yeah. I really, 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 really shouldn't kick the bucket. Not yet. I'm gonna go bandage up my face and I think I need some time to myself, so just to try and clear my head. Why don't you try to get some sleep? I'll be back later to check on you and try to bring you something to eat. Have a good nap, hon.